There we are. Greetings, everyone. Welcome. We're started. Greetings, seekers. Hello, everyone. It's time to learn the meaning of life. So, if you are seeking the meaning of life, if you'd like to know what it all means, well, here it is. The meaning of life is to clear your throat before starting a video, because you'll have a frog in your throat, and it'll ruin the whole gravitas of the whole situation. I wanted to be all composed, like, greetings, oh seekers of life, of the meaning. Let's frickin' do this. The meaning of life is fish. It's to get the Holy Grail. It's the meaning of life is to get the Holy Grail. That's morning. What God.
Morning.
Morning. That's what God told me to do.
Morning. What's new? Not much.
Fish.
Morning.
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 Hey, look. How it's being eaten.
You see?
Makes you think, doesn't it?
I mean, what's it all about?
Beats me.
Why are we here? Okay, the video clip is acting funny. The video clip is small and in the corner. Okay. Well, anyways, this is the video from the,
The producers of this game are sensitive to the beliefs and concerns of people of all creeds,
I didn't play test this.
And philosophical points of view. Therefore, we deem it essential to alert anyone who may belong to one or more of the following groups that the material contained herein is particularly disgusting. Please read.
It's probably best that I didn't show that particular video because there might be a copyright issue, but that's just the video from The Meaning of Life that we skipped earlier and that was not coming in at all and in the corner in a weird way. All right. Fair enough. As long as the game works. Oh, we have to keep going. It may be offensive to Catholics, Presbyterians, Jewish scientists, or Christian scientists, Mormons, Normans, Jews, fish, Anglicans, animists, Lutherans, anthropomorphists, Shiite Muslims, Iranians, Baha'i world faithists, Rastafarians, loonies, liberals, Zoroastrians, sticklers for detail, Jutes, Picts, Celts, Scots, men with huge breasts, phlegmatics, larches, transcendentalists, pensive swimmers of the deep, communist practitioners of animal husbandry, Coptic Christians, head people, a lot of stuff. Read it all. I'm not going to read all of this, or we're going to be here for a while. Pessimists, holy rollers, nice old ladies who need disciplining, fetishists, Buddhists, Freemasons, finger pointers, astrologists, Hittites, Nazis, killer whale worshippers. This goes on for a while. Vegetarians, goats, chickens, and fictional characters. If you belong to one of these groups,
one of these options.
I will continue. Good to see you, Sam. Hello. Welcome to the stream. Thanks for dropping by. I will continue and accept full responsibility for my actions. I will continue and accept no responsibility for my actions. I will not continue, but I accept full responsibility of the actions of others. I don't understand any of this, and where's my nanny? Does this actually make me leave?
I bet you're wondering what this game is about.
No, okay, cool.
In the same boat, so to speak. What is the meaning of life, anyway?
The Holy Grail?
Play on, my friend, and maybe we'll all find out.
All right. Is that rolling? Yeah, it's recording properly. Cool. All right. I was a little bit worried when the other thing didn't work properly, but... All right, so...
Go ahead. Flush me. Won't bother me a bit. I'm a professional.
Oh, okay. Birth. Life is a toilet. It's the cycle. The universe is like a cycle. It's a spiral universe in which you're spiraling into different...
The miracle of birth.
I don't know. I was trying to make some sort of weird connection.
It's a bit bare in here, isn't it? Yes, more apparatus, please, nurse.
More apparatus.
The EEG, the BP monitor, and the AVV.
Yes, certainly, Doc.
And get the machine that goes ping. And get
the machine that goes ping.
In case the administrator comes.
And the most expensive machine. Thank you, I appreciate that.
That's better, that's much, much better. Yes, more like it.
I think they added extra.
Still something missing, though.
Like more machines than there were in the movie, The Patient. Where's...
For the ladies.
For the ladies.
Where's the patient?
Anyone's in there? Patient!
Patient! What? It crashed! It's not supposed to crash. Somebody should have play tested this, apparently.
A disclaimer.
Can we get it not to crash? I'm a bit worried that... I'm a bit worried I might have to go to Plan B. I didn't want to play test it because I didn't want to ruin the jokes for myself, you know? And it's like I wanted to keep the jokes fresh, but if I had to play through it some, I would, you know, I'd remind myself of what everything is, and I wouldn't get the genuine laughter.
Please choose one.
But, you know, I thought it looked like it was working. Where's Nanny? Oh, where's Nanny makes you exit. Where's Nanny is the exit game? Well, the other one didn't exit. It said I would not continue further, but I accepted all responsibility for everyone else. That's just one I did the first time, and it was cool. Apparently, they're not okay with people who need to see their nanny. Well, at least I'm still getting a few laughs, but please don't lock up for me. Yeah, I accept full responsibility for everything. Nice. Don't lock up on me.
Part one.
I want to be born. I was just a baby boy.
More contractions are more frequent, Doctor.
Good, take her into the fetus frightening room.
Right.
All right, shut up. Get the machines. Okay. Yay! It didn't lock up. I don't know why it locked up the first time.
Here she is.
I don't know why it did that. I was worried we were going to have like a fatal error.
Come along. Hello, now don't you worry.
We'll soon have you cured.
Leave it all to us. You'll never know what hit you.
You know, bugs, they're part of life. It's part of... I think that's part of the meaning of life is... Yeah, whatever. Something.
The administrator is here.
Philosophy.
Doctor.
Switch everything on!
Switch everything on! Everything on! Everything needs a switch. Switchy switch. Please don't lock up. Play with the scale. It's important. You know, I'm actually running this off of the CD in Windows XP mode, so... You know, there's like a lot of compatibility things that could go wrong. That's why I am kind of, pins and needles about, like... I feel like this game could lock up at any second. We're barely holding it together, Captain. It's about to lock up your Wii. The Wii computers, the emulation can't take anymore, Captain. Take it easy with the clicking. Okay.
Morning, gentlemen.
Morning.
Morning, Mr. Pycroft.
Oh,
very impressive, very impressive. And what are you doing this morning?
It's a birth.
Ah, what sort of thing is that?
Well, that's when we take a new baby out of a lady's tummy.
Wonderful thing you can do nowadays. I see you have the machine that goes bing. This is my favorite. You see, we leased this back from the company we sold it to, and that way it comes under the monthly current budget and not the capital account. Thank you, thank you.
That's all right.
We do our best. Well, do carry on.
You know, I don't think there's a lot of people searching for Monty Python games right now, so, you know, but I'm glad you're here, at least. People will, filter in later.
That's the machine that goes...
If they don't watch it live.
You see, that means your baby is still alive.
But, you know, this is one of those ones that I'm playing for myself, so.
Can I put the tube in the baby's head?
Only if I can do the episiotomy.
Okay.
There you go.
What do I do?
Yes?
What do I do?
Nothing, dear. You're not qualified.
Leave it to us.
All right, I got this birth under control.
And that's the most expensive machine in the whole hospital.
Yes, it cost over £750,000.
Aren't you lucky?
That expensive machine, it's It's gonna take care of everything. Alright, so what do I do next? I'm an expert, don't worry, lady. We've got this. Doctors, do you want to do anything? No? I mean, I'm the doctor, I got this. Play with the scale some more. Don't stop playing with the scale. Oh, we do click on her again.
Oh, okay. Yes, there's the head. Yes, 4 centimeters, 5, 6 centimeters.
Light! Amplify the ping machine.
Master suction. Eyes down for a full house.
More
here
ping.
Here it comes.
Well, at least we get a coin for that silliness.
Oh, 1 penny.
A 1 penny. Ooh, 1 penny. And we've introduced the inventory system. This weird, silly face thing. Didn't look healthy for the baby, but that's fine. That's life. That is indeed life.
Eyes down for a full house. Here it comes!
What? It already came. Oh, okay, there's more. Of course. This is when we get silly and surreal. Okay, that's apparently. What do we do now? Birth has occurred. We have acquired the penny. Do I move on to the next stage of life, or do I clicky click more somewhere else?
Eyes down!
Is that... No, birth isn't... We're not done with birth yet. Okay, don't tell me I have to go through that scenario again. Okay, yeah, we... Oh, I have to follow... this game. There we go. Weird logic.
The third world.
The third world, part 2. Right.
Oh, get that, would you, Deirdre?
That one.
Oh, bloody hell.
All right, then. Let's just go in here. The point is, I want to complete this game. I never did. The big debutinates coalition, is to take place in a mere few 4 weeks, and Mrs. Wedgeworth Crutchinson asked you to send out the invitations post-haste. You know that Monty Python and Seven Level are in bed together, so you decide to invite them both on the same invitation. However, not wanting to insult them, you need to address the envelope in a manner that it reflects their true relationship. With this in mind, you pick up the quill and write, Monty Python and Seventh Level, Seventh Level Monty Python, the great Monty Python and their lackeys, Seventh Level... Associates. Okay. That was supposed to be a joke. It didn't really work for me. Either till 12 o'clock or as long as it takes. No. I could... At least 12 o'clock, maybe longer. 2 hours.
I've got something to tell the whole family.
Oh, quick. Go and get the others in, Gordon.
At least 2 hours. Maybe more if I'm, like, up to it. We'll see.
There's no more work. We're destitute. Come in, my little loves.
I've got no option but to sell you all for scientific experiments.
Just tons of children. Sell you all for medical experiments.
Blame the Catholic Church for not letting me wear one of those little rubber things. Oh, they've done some wonderful things in their time.
They've preserved the might and majesty, even mystery of the Church of Rome. And the sanctity of the sacraments, the indivisible oneness of the Trinity.
But if they let me wear one of those little rubber things on the end of my cock, we won't be in the mess we are now.
EST. I'm on EST. So, yeah, Eastern Standard Time, 12 o'clock. So, it's 10:13 for me right now. Because, yeah, I'm on Eastern Standard Time. And, is the current Pope against contraceptives? I think he is. I think, have they still, or he isn't, like, vocal about it, but I don't think Roman Catholics are pro-contraception. Or are they? I don't know, actually. I don't know how if that's... Or has that changed? A lot of things have changed. No, I don't think he is as quite as... Yeah, 10:14. So yeah, you're on the same time. I don't know. Well, anyways, they used to be... I remember Pope John Paul being really against contraception, but I don't know about the Pope Francis, this current Pope, because he's, you know, a lot cooler about a lot of things, and, you know, it's like the HIV situation in Africa, it seems like it'd be... I don't know. Anyways.
Couldn't Mummy have worn some sort of pessary?
Not if we're going to remain members of the fastest growing religion in the world, my boy. You see...
Weird aside for
we
me.
Believe... Well, let me put it like this.
There are Jews in the world. There are Buddhists. There are Hindus and Mormons and them. There are those that follow Mohammed's but I've never been one of them.
The animation's kind of funny.
I'm a Roman.
It's like I've seen the song before.
And have been since before I was born.
Fair enough.
And the one thing they say about Catholics is they'll take you as soon as you're warm. You don't have to be a six-footer. You don't have to have a great brain.
You know, I think I'm going to skip the song because, you know, it is in the movie.
So you see my problem.
There we go. Fair enough.
I can't keep
stop singing. Stop singing.
Speak up.
I can't keep you all here any longer. God has blessed us so much, I can't afford to feed you anymore. No, no, that's the way it is, my loves.
Can you have your balls cut off?
It's not a simple thing. God knows all. What we do to ourselves, we do to him.
You could have had them pulled off in an accident.
No, no, children, I know you're trying to help, but believe me, my mind's made up. I've given this long and careful thought, and it has to be medical experiments for the lot of you.
Alright, so what am I trying to achieve here other than watching,
Right, move along, please. There's nothing more to see here. Nothing except a room full of grimy little Catholic children.
Okay, thank you. Thank you, officer. I'm gonna move along. You know, there's a lot of interesting little clips here. A lot of interesting... bits of... Can I move along? 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 Where exit? Where go I do?
Right, move.
Yes, you... Oh, thank you. Thank you. He was pointing to it. He was pointing to it. Okay. All right, who left the window open? Now, rare hairless female woodchuck has come in with the breeze and is doing an exotic dance all over Grandma Wuggles' fish-baked muffins. I say shoot the woodchuck. You say the more satisfying thing to do would be throw a net, something, keep her as a pet, stuff like a trophy. It's a weird, weird question. It's... Hairless. Well, I guess the pet thing or the chase. More saddest. Sure, pet.
Nay without guess. Your penny. Nay without your penny. Are you nay forgetting something?
Nay without my penny. Sure.
Harry, I want you to sell me a condom. In fact,
a condom, yes.
There you go.
One penny condoms. A French tickler.
Ooh, a condom. A French tickler.
So now what do we do with this? I have succeeded. I've succeeded the puzzle. In the puzzle. Okay. Do I give the dude a condom? Answer or be mocked. You have a private meeting with Pope, the Pope and the Dalai Lama. The most memorable event at the meeting you can imagine is if the Pope approached the Dalai Lama and, wait, the most memorable event, or wait, The question is, the most memorable events that you can imagine, that I can imagine. Well, I mean, if he did that, that would be very memorable. That's all I'm saying. You know, it'd be hard to forget that one. French tickler, sir? What?
No, that's the way it is, my love.
Ah, yeah. You don't care for contraceptives. Okay, well, somebody has to use this. Okay, yeah, let me get out of here. Let's face it. Nature films are great fun, especially when a predatory beast brings down a litter of other animals, let's say a gazelle, and eats it. But still, you think it's much more enjoyable if it would be occasionally a dead gazelle's ghost rose up from the carcass, danced around, rattled some chains, and then made a whole assortment of spooky noises, until the terrified beast begged to be choked, mercilessly licked, stabbed, or slowly consumed. Mercilessly licked? By the ghost? I mean, you know, there's this one, you know, Japanese ghosts have a weird way of haunting people by doing that once or twice, but they're weird in Japanese. There was, like, the kid clown, the ghost that would lick you and you'd turn blue from, like, terror. It was weird. There was a weird... anyways, why would you, even though you're being scared, I wouldn't beg to have any of these happen to me. Licked, I guess. Because that's weird. Because that's just weird. Oh, you can turn the frickin' screen. Well, there you are.
My name's Innocent. Innocent by name, but not by nature.
Innocent by name, but not my nature.
You might be surprised.
All the vicars are dirty.
Immaculate Conception, she says. Likely bloody story.
I forgot to tell you. Once you've had it immaculate, you'll never go back to doing it any other way.
He was handsome, all right. But the power and glory and the mystery of the Lord is no substitute for a good cuddle.
Yes, my friends, if you're the lucky 10 billionth soul to follow me onto the path of righteousness, you'll receive a brand new snack tech food dehydrator. Great for apples, bananas, apricots, beef jerky, and the body of Christ.
I was a carpenter myself. Bloody ironic, if you ask me. A cross is more than just two boards nailed together. It takes time, and patience, and love. That's what it takes.
Alright, moving right along. well, thank you for that, Jesus. Thanks for the bits of advice.
Bloody Catholics.
Oh, you're the guy who needs the condom, right. The Protestants. Protestants can use condoms. Yes, you need a condom.
Look at them.
Apparently. A French tickler. That's exactly what she needs.
Oh, thank you. Would you care for some cream?
Oh, sure.
Cream!
Oh, that's it. Okay. Oh no, I got cream. Oh, we can switch. Oh, I can go wherever I want? Oh, we got the birth item. We got cream. Okay, yeah, that's the objective. The meaning of birth, the meaning of the cream. What? We got cream. I'm not gonna try to figure out game logic here. This is Monty Python. Let's get on with our lives.
Meaning of life, part two.
Growth and learning.
And spotteth twice they the camels before the third hour. And so the Midianites went forth to Ram Gilead in Kadesh Bilgameth, by Shor Ether Regalion to the house of Gash Bil Bethuel Basda, he who brought the batter dish to Belshazzar and the tent peg to the house of Rashomon. And there slew they the goats, yea, and placed they the bits in little pots. Here endeth the lesson.
Chaplain?
Let us praise God. O Lord.
O Lord.
Oh, you are so big.
So big.
Ooh, you are so big.
So absolutely huge.
So absolutely huge.
Gosh, we're all really impressed down here, I can tell you.
Gosh, we're all really impressed down here, I can tell you.
Forgive us, O Lord, for this our dreadful toadying. But you're so strong and, well, just so super.
This is a baptismal font. It is full of holy water.
Indeed, the water is holy. Okay, so apparently I'm supposed to use something on this, but I don't have... Because that's what the hand gesture... I remember the hand gesture means you put something here. But I don't have the thing in which to put here, so... Alright. Guess let's keep listening to this nonsense.
I do wish you'd pay attention. Otherwise, there's no point in doing this at all, is there?
Well, I mean, you put things and stuff. That's kind of the point.
There, I've finished.
Okay, what now? Good to know. That's the general theme of a lot of the jokes. Okay. Right. I mean, yes, thank you for that. I mean, I do have to worry about the rating. I do forget what was in these movies. I mean, it's that's okay. But yeah, I didn't all enable right. An age restriction, so I forgot. Well, thank you for that though. It's so what else? Right, over here. That's where we're supposed to go. Okay. Answer be mocked. While attending a prestigious private school, you constantly overhear Janice and faculty referring to your naughty bits as Janice. Janice was your mother's name, and you consider this unorthodox, and the use of the name to be a grave insult. You confront them and tell them to stop. They agree, but they insist that you choose a phrase to take Janice's place, and you think long and hard and finally come upon the decision. Laxative-filled tomato, chunk of rancid lard, moldy piece of head cheese, spicy little mystery treat. Head cheese is kind of a moldy head cheese? That's what I chose. Answer and be mocked. I'm thinking what he's thinking over here.
I got a triple fracture of the right leg, dislocated collarbone, and multiple head injuries.
Okay, he's got a bird in his desk. And the, there was like a joke about putting oil on the cormorant, which is a bird. So I think I gotta give him, like, some sort of linseed oil. I gotta get linseed oil and give it to him. That was the joke. That was the joke from the movie. Seems like some of these jokes would be kind of hard to figure out if you hadn't seen the movie. Alright then. Okay. You had laundry on your head. Ah, right.
He's coming!
Alright, so this is basically just a rerun of the...
Now, before I begin the lesson, will those of you who are playing in the match this afternoon move your clothes down onto the lower peg immediately after lunch? Before you write your letter home, if you're not getting your hair cut, unless you've got a younger brother who's going out this weekend as the guest of another boy, in which case collect his note before lunch, put it in your letter after you've had your hair cut, and make sure he moves your clothes down onto the lower peg for you. Sir? Sir? Sir?
My younger brother's going out with Dibble this weekend, sir, but I'm not having my hair cut today, sir, so do I move my clothes
down?
You
should listen, Weimer. It's perfectly simple. If you're not getting your hair cut...
All right. Well, that's just basically from the script from the movie.
Sex.
It's very simple.
Sex.
Sex.
Where were we? Dibble!
vaginal juices.
Yes, sir.
Name two ways of getting them flowing.
All right. There's probably... Okay, don't do that. Don't do that.
Name two ways...
Oh, okay, somebody's got to, yeah, answer it. It's funny stuff, but it's like, I want to make progress in this game.
Suck the nipple.
Okay. And? Anyone else?
Biting the thigh, sir.
There we go. Alright.
Biting the neck. And of course, tonguing will give you the best idea.
Good, good. Alright. Or, no, not that again. Well, what else do I do then?
Oh, God.
You.
Suck the nipples.
Okay, yes, yes. Wasn't that two? You just need two things, right? Click on another dude. Oh, you.
Oh, was it taking your clothes off, sir?
Oh. I skipped the part where he got his head smacked off by the
striking the thigh.
The teacher? That was weird. Okay, well, I thought it was just going to be the typical stuff in this skit.
The best idea of how the juices are... And of course...
What, wasn't there a fast way to get through this? Okay, no.
Rubbing the clitoris.
Striking the thighs.
Click on every student. No, that wasn't that couldn't have been the end of it. That's not the right way. Oh well. It's late at night. You're alone. Suddenly, someone grabs you. Answer me the smarty trousers. Somebody grabs you from behind. You try wetting yourself, but it does no good. You scream. You go limp. You emit the scent of a poisonous sea sponge. Still no good. In desperation, you yell at the one thing that would scare you more than anyone else if you were in your attacker's position. Oh, you scream. Don't look now, but here come my allies. The fearless, amazing kickboxing old ladies. Because if you fight them, you might kill them. I guess. That one's less silly. Yeah, this is not... Okay. There was something really simple there. Blah, blah, blah. You believe that if you were allowed in the priesthood... If you were allowed in the priesthood, the church should force you to... Well... They should force you to... Vomit in a crowded bus? Or slam your... You vomit in a crowded bus. Why not? Go for it. So he got his head back. Because I probably reset this whole process. No. Wasn't there... There's got to be something different I click on. I just... Or is it just having the... teacher keep talking? Blah,
name,
blah.
Naming
two ways. And,
rubbing the...
Great. Well, this is awkward.
Striking the thigh, sir.
Yes, good.
Yes.
Rubbing the...
So that's two ways, right? Shouldn't it just be two?
Biting the...
Oh. Good for you. Okay, well... yes. There's gonna be a certain amount of that sort of thing. It's...
Could you kindly wait? I'm warning you! I may decide to set an exam this... Could you kindly wake up? I have no intention of going through this all again.
Alright. What am I... Oh! There we go. That? Is that what I'm supposed to do? You don't know... You really don't care how you die. No, you really don't. You could be conked on the head with a jet aeroplane or impaled by an experimental steam-driven breakfast sausage. But what does it matter? You're going to die anyway, so, and there's nothing you can do about it. You're all concerned... All you're concerned about is when you die, your soul is eternally cared for by... your personal deity, an omnipotent being, a universal force, a very nice old man in a red suit. Well, he's at least his. I like the color choice of the suit, I suppose. I don't know. Obviously, your personal deity, you could, you know, you could choose something really nice there. So,
hello, my name.
We'll go for that one.
My name is Kenneth. Hello there. I'm Kenneth. Hi, I'm Kenneth. Hello, everybody. My name is. Hello, my name is Ken. Hello, my name is Kenneth. Hello, good evening. My name is. Hello. 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 My name is Kenneth Van der Blip.
Okay. You don't know John. Like when there was, you don't know Jack.
Oh, Terry, sorry.
Hello and welcome to You Don't Know John, the program where modern erudition and historical knowledge clash within a competitive context. My name is Kenneth Van der Burlap, and I shall be your host.
Hey, he did it.
Explain the rules of the game, shall we?
Well done,
there
Kenneth.
There are 7 questions per game. You have a limited amount of time, so be sure to select your answer just as soon as you can.
All right.
Everybody ready?
Yes.
Good. Off we go. Question number 1.
Classified nuclear secrets. Dogs who shave. KXV-729 Series 2 experimental category.
Any category. The name of this category is... KXV-729 Series 2 Experimental Category.
Good luck.
A correct answer will be worth £5.
Oh, good.
And here is your question. If Sally rushed into a secret meeting of the United Nations Security Council wearing nothing but a slice of salami and smashed half a grapefruit into the face of each delegate from a permanent member nation, which of the following nations would not have a delegate whose face was covered in grapefruit juice? 1. The United Kingdom. 2. France. 3. China. 4. Suriname.
Wait, if a delegate from a permanent member nation... Who would not?
You're absolutely right. Suriname is not a permanent member of the United Nations Security Council.
Okay.
And in fact couldn't get invited if it wanted to because it is silly, tiny, and stupid.
Everything else was a distraction.
Number 2.
And it did distract very well. What if Sally is naked? Yeah, well done on that. Amputee time.
Category. At all.
My dear wooden kidney are too much complex. The much too complex category.
Category 1, category 2, or category 3.
I kind of like 1 and I kind of like 3. 3. I like the comedy category.
This category is the much too complex category.
But I really liked Amputee Time. That was funny.
£10. And here is your question. Listen very carefully. I'm going to ask you for a woody word now. Not a tinny word, but a woody word. Now listen and pick the woody word.
Well, this is easy.
1. Simpkins.
Simpkins!
Two,
no.
3.
Git.
Caribou.
Tinny,
4.
Tinny.
Tit.
Oh, tit. I mean, caribou. That's a good woody word.
Oh, simply nifty. Oh, damn. I've come and used some tinny words. All right. You have a lovely pouty mouth.
Hey there, Francisco Mora, and a robot. Good to see you.
3.
Welcome. Choose this category and win big money. Ducks in the pantry. Witty quotes of Stonehenge. Well, I mean...
The name of this category is... Choose this category and win big money. A correct answer will be worth... £15.
Well, it is equal to what I have, but...
Is your question. Following is a list of men who have served as president of the Philippines along with their policy on worms. Please select the president whose listed policy is accurate. 1. Emilio Aguinaldo hated worms. 2. Marino hated worms. 3. Diosdado Macapagal was ambivalent about worms. 4. Manuel Roja y Acuña. I'm afraid that's all the time we can give.
What?
You. Sorry, let's try another, shall we?
What do you mean all the time we have? You didn't even finish. I thought I had time to listen to the question. Tomorrow 7 o'clock for the Roblox, and then 10 o'clock for what was it? Don't Starve Together. Chimpanzees Who Attended Oxford. Not a chance in hell you'll get those one right. Or toupees that changed the world.
For you to choose a category. The name of this category is not a chance in hell you'll get this one right. A correct answer will be worth...
Why did I choose that?
£25. And here is your question. The Great Western Schism of the 14th and 15th centuries saw no fewer than 9 different popes in 3 different cities assume the throne of the Catholic.
What?
The Avignon Papacy was the most controversial...
Mystery answer.
Primarily...
Mystery answer.
The mystery answer is none of the above, and that is correct. Although Pope Innocent VII was
yes!
fond of lucky charms, he had outlawed them as a material evil, and thus could only eat them privately with his mistress.
They were going to time me out, otherwise I'd interrupt the question.
5.
Evolution of Siri Walks. Category 12, or weeds that can be eaten but do not taste very good. Oh, I like them all.
Choose a category.
Category. Weeds. Oh, why?
But do not taste very good.
Why did I choose this one?
Will be worth £50. And here is your question. If you've been playing this game correctly up to this point, the answer to this question will be obvious. 1. Up 3 spaces.
The mystery spot.
Oh, that's too bad, but please don't be too disappointed.
Damn.
We'll ask you this question again later.
Well, what was it? I have not been playing this game correctly up till this point. You bastards. Heroic penguins of the Crimean War, how not to be seen, the thing which hangs down inside a whale's throat. I don't know what that... How not to be seen.
The name of this category is... How not to be seen. A correct answer will be worth 100.
I'm at negative 10?
And here is your question. What is being a Protestant all about?
I didn't know they penalized me.
Freedom from papal dictates. 2. Following the teachings of Martin Luther. 3. Eating as much pig and goat as you desire. 4. Being able to wear a rubber sheath.
Yeah, 4.
Yes, good show. Being a Protestant means being able to wear a rubber sheath over your old fellow.
That's what it's all about.
For that matter.
All right, at least I'm positive again. All right, Final John. Good.
Well, now it's time for Final John, the last round of our competition, so I shall explain the rules. If you have 2 words to form a match, then by pressing...
Oh, screw you.
That's all there is to it. Now, please select a category.
I heard match. All right, infamous dictators who made people laugh on Control V, the wrong category. In the insignificant huge battles of...
The category you have chosen is...
Why?
The wrong category.
Why?
So you can be relatively sure that your matches will have nothing to do with that. Every time you are right, you will be awarded money. However, every time you are wrong, money will be taken away. Please remember the words moving from side to side will not be considered a match unless they fit the clue, which descends slowly from the top to the bottom of your screen. Now, assuming these rules are understood, let's begin with Final John.
Wait. Oh. No. Oh. Wait. Things that have... Europe. Okay, I get it. I get it. I have to show restraint. A refrigerator full of chinchillas. There we go. I get it. Wait. I miss Miss Pyongyang. That might have been... No. In the pageant of the unicycles. Okay, so this is actually pretty easy. You just wait, and then they finally give you the right answer after a bunch of wrong answers that are silly. Mom's Hornet Pie. Okay, well then this is... Well, thank you for that. Mosquitoes the size of tiny flies. Made of Velcro. Oh. There's the save game option. That's important. Okay, so it's just giving me... This is giving me continents and nations. Okay, well this is feeling kind of silly now. When will we be done with this? Soon? Yes? Antarctica's famous pastries and millions of hibernating underground Hulk human-killing ice creatures coming out of, to a close friend, Iceberg Kyle.
Mmm, very impressive. Well,
few jokes
the
there.
End of our competition.
Good.
I hope you enjoyed it as thoroughly as I did.
The ending was kind of boring, but.
Well done, Blair. You made it into our pantheon of...
Current player who isn't as dim as we originally thought.
...in recognition of this very important achievement, we present you with this.
Damn, stuck-up, friendless, unabashedly friendless, stuck-up, and egg-headed, get much smarter than Einstein, aren't you clever Smith, expert on everything, quitting amazing Brainy Jr., and hard thinker the third, retired. Ooh.
A bottle of linseed oil!
A bottle of linseed oil! Ooh! Alright, that, and now I know what to do.
Again, if you wish. See if you can beat your own score, if that is humanly possible. And again, remember, regardless of how much knowledge you've accumulated over the years, and how much school you've attended, or whether or not you have an advanced degree, or you're exhaustively well-read in one subject or a number of subjects, the point to always keep in mind is that you don't know John.
Well, I'm in the pantheon of terribly smart people, so aren't I terribly smart? Monarchies are fine for old folks, but young people expect more for their tax money than pomp and pageantry, so why not put the monarchy to work? The queen is said to be very handy with a roving hammer, and the Prince of Wales has often remarked that he'd rather enjoy walking about among the people and pumping out their septic tanks. But what of the Queen Mum? You strongly feel her free time would be best spent exterminating rodents, rubbing up against people's legs, giving lonely people love and companionship on a cold winter's night, or hissing at bad people. Well, I think, obviously, so you're basically saying that she can do everything a cat can do. Well, let's go with hissing at bad people. All right. Linseed oil. Hello. Thank you. Here you go, buddy. Put linseed oil on that bird for some reason.
Yes, sir. Sorry, sir.
Ooh, an empty bottle.
We had to do it to empty out the bottle. I can't get rid of perfectly good linseed oil. I have to get somebody to use it. You have been just chosen the winner in the world's wacky, in the wackiest bastard in the world pageant. To show television audiences that you really are wacky, you chose to strut down the runway bearing a banner which reads, "Look who's pooping, I'm a twit, Spittle's my mentor, Mummy's little monkey." Let's go with that one, because I like acting like a silly monkey. All right. I was thinking of dipping it in the font, but that works too. That's more interesting.
Ooh. Water.
Water. He just looks so happy, that guy. All right, we're happy about water. Fighting each other, right. Chapter 3. Fighting each other. It's an important part of life.
Of life, part three, fighting each other.
That's what kids do. At a certain stage, suddenly, warfare. The pirates. That was like my favorite skit in that, was the pirates. The insurance pirates. That was a hilarious skit, because I love pirates and I love old people acting silly. Alright, yes. Let's get up on this hill. Get up on that hill, soldier!
Well, of course, warfare isn't all fun.
Okay, so he desires an object. Oh, yeah, that's not gonna work. But that's just another clip from the game or from the movie, which you know, you can just watch the movie if you want to see that. Right.
Oh, that's much better. Thank you, honey.
You're welcome.
Do I get something for this, or am I just clicking stuff? Hey, here's a bunch of images we have. Would you like to click them repeatedly? We'll call it a shooting gallery. Isn't this fun? And the same images pop up in the same spot, so you start to get used to the shape of the targets. Particularly that little group of footballers there is kind of hard until you know about his location. So I do I get a reward? Reward for this? I think we're gonna be at this forever, right? Yeah, thank you for that. I should have figured that out a while ago.
Oh, fishy, 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 fish. It is the most elusive fish. Oh, fishy, 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 fish.
Angry Zulu warriors. Oh.
Fishy, fishy, fishy.
Did I just get shot? Yes, I did.
Oh, fishy, 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 fish.
All right, this. And I have that person saying, "Oh, fishy, fishy, fish" in the background.
Oh, fishy, fishy,
well, isn't this annoying? Thank you. Shut up! Shut it! So that was basically just an advertisement for the movie right over there. Thank you for buying a game in which we advertise a movie to you. I mean, obviously.
Today we're gonna do marching up.
A lot of this is that, but I didn't think there would actually be a promotional thing. So wait.
It's all very well to.
You want an item? Where item get I? I must get item. Not you. Not that. Clicked on that. Just go around clicking on crap.
Good evening, ladies.
Eventually something good will happen. You're oh fishy fishy fish. Shut up. Shut up, you angry Zulu warriors. The cannon that puts the thing up on my face. There's nothing over here. Okay, hey guys. Did I just not persist on the shooting gallery long enough? I hope not. Please tell me it's not that. Oh, can I just like keep going? Do I keep going? It's like somewhere past here. I feel disappointed that I'm getting stuck here. I could go to a different chapter. I don't think we bring things from other chapters, though.
And without the ability to defend one's own viewpoint against other, perhaps more aggressive ideologies, then reasonableness and moderation could quite simply disappear. That is why we'll always need an army, and may God strike me down were it to be otherwise. May God strike me down were it to be otherwise. May God...
Okay, that's the hint. May God strike me down to be otherwise. Like, we need... We need, like, the hand of God to strike him down. The hand of God. Is it, like, up there? Can I grab it? Let's save the game. Maybe I can just go to a different chapter. I mean, we can just go to the next chapter, Middle Age. There's nothing holding me back.
Middle Age.
Middle Age. Yeah, I'm stuck here. I'll go somewhere else.
Good evening. Would you care for something to talk about?
Sure, why not?
Hello, I'm Diane. I'm your waitress for tonight. Okay, fine. Thank you, sir.
These are the Henders. They are trying to have a conversation. The problem? They have nothing to talk about. Your job? Choose a topic from the menu. Then you decide what Mr. Hendy says. Mrs. Hendy will do the rest. If you're smart, you'll figure out how to finish the conversation. If you're not smart, well, good luck. Because with the Hendys, you'll need all the luck you can get.
Have a nice conversation.
All right, well, we went from one, you know, we went from a difficult puzzle to an extremely difficult situation. Having a conversation, good God. What should I talk about? A conversation, it's Conversation Simulator 1995. When was this game made? Kind of curious now. My CD my thing's cracked, but it's yeah, 1997. I nailed it. 1997. Booyah. Sex.
Sex is nice, and I think sex is cute. When we're having sex,
it's cute.
A real swell time.
I like a big variety in my sex. Or sex is... You said it. Sex is okay. Sometimes sex is scary. Let's go with the...
I like a big variety in my sex. Sometimes I like to have sex at 9 o'clock. But 10 o'clock is too late for me. At 10 o'clock, I like to be asleep, not having sex.
That's not exactly big variety.
Sex is making me tired. What else is there to talk about?
Sex.
Sex is nice, I think so.
Oh, we're in a loop. Okay, sex is scary.
Sometimes sex is scary. Like when I think of hurricanes when I'm having sex, then that can sometimes make me scared. Let's stop talking about sex because I'm getting scared.
I'm scared. Oh, these two people are too innocent. Sure, minorities.
Minorities are nice, and I think minorities are cute. There should be lots of minorities all over the place.
Everything is nice and cute. Oh, so I gotta be like her. Yeah. I like minorities who are jolly. Minorities sure do funny things. They sure do enjoy music. I feel like we're on very unstable ground here. Some places have plenty of minorities. They sure do. Well, I do.
I like minorities who are jolly.
That sounds like
sometimes
her.
Sometimes jolly people get naked. I'm sure glad people aren't naked all the time. That would be embarrassing. Let's find something else to talk about.
Okay. Politics.
Politicians are nice. And I think politicians are cute. They do lots of fascinating stuff in politics.
Politicians are rarely cute.
Marvin?
Or nice. You bet.
You bet. Long speeches are boring. But short ones aren't so boring as the long ones are. Come to think of it, politics are not fascinating. Let's not talk about politics anymore.
Otters are nice. And I think otters are cute. They're real lovable creatures. Baby seals are almost as lovable as otters are.
Otters are nice, and I think otters are cute. Bam, that's the one.
Otters are nice.
Naked, yes.
And I think otters are cute. Otters are all sorts of colors, too. Lunchboxes have plenty of colors. I once saw a lunchbox that was purple.
Oh, we got an applause.
This
yes.
This conversation is great. We should keep having this conversation because this conversation has been really super interesting.
Okay. Oh, I can look around. There's a bunch of him. Okay, well, we'll focus on the task at hand. Good to see you again, Amadeus. Alright, let's keep having our conversation. This conversation is great. If we keep talking about the same thing, it will be swell. What we're talking about makes me think of lemons. That's risky. If we keep talking about the same thing, it'll be swell.
If we keep talking about the same thing,
maybe
it will be swell. Or we could decide to talk about batteries. Batteries are pretty useful.
Aw, damn, boo!
I don't like this conversation anymore.
Damn.
Let's start again.
Alright, otters are nice, otters are cute. Okay. Lemons. It makes me think of lemons. This conversation's great. Lemons.
What we're talking about makes me think of lemons. Lemons are a real neat fruit.
They're neat.
You can paint a picture of one if you want to paint something that's yellow.
Damn. Nope. She doesn't like it.
Otter.
This conversation is great.
This conversation is great. You said it. Say, does the circus start with F? I like the circus.
As airheaded as possible.
Circus once? Our seats were pretty good because they were right in front of the clowns. The clowns were real funny.
Baby elephants walled in circles with the went to the circus once. Clowns were great. Probably, or I like the acrobats. The acrobats were super. I don't know. It could be either. I don't think it's the bottom two. I think it's one of the top two, but I'm not sure which one. Clowns real funny. Just parrot her. Just be like her.
The clowns were great. They made me laugh so that I forgot all my troubles.
Damn it. Damn it. Okay, see. This conversation's great. Wait, what is it? Acrobats.
The acrobats
are super.
Because the acrobats were super. I'm sure glad there wasn't any hot lava.
Hot lava? Damn it. I was wrong. Alright, so, wait. Yeah. This conversation's great. We went to the circus once. Airheaded.
You're right. We sat where the red seats were. There were lots of funny lions. Lions eat people, but they don't eat peanuts.
There we go. Gotta be stupid. Gotta think stupid.
Butter. You can buy some that's smooth, or you can get it chunky. And you can mix it with lots of different things to make a real good sandwich.
All right. Peanut butter has lots of textures. I like peanut butter. I think strawberry jelly is good, and so is raspberry. Peanut butter is like pineapples. Yes, that's the one, because it's stupid.
Peanut butter's like pineapples. You know, it's real
it's
important
as stupid
to
as it
swallow,
gets.
Or you won't be able to talk.
No, okay. There, damn. We went to the circus once. That's too far off topic. Peanut butter has lots of textures. Real basic. Or I like peanut butter. Or is it a jelly? Damn, this isn't easy. I like peanut butter. You can buy some that's smooth or get it chunky. Oh, yeah, yeah, because he's talking about... It has lots
peanut
of textures, yes.
Has a lot of textures. Textures remind me of Texas.
Damn. All right, I don't get the logic here. Just I like it or jelly? Last time, if I just agreed with her, Yeah, it's this
I think
one.
Strawberry jelly is good.
This is good.
And
that's
so
good.
So is raspberry. Marmalade is made out of orange peels. So let's not talk about marmalade.
Oh, it is. It's the last one I did. Yeah, I like peanut butter.
Like
just agree.
Peanut butter, just like you do. I wonder who invented peanut butter. There sure must be a lot of good inventors.
Yeah, it's just really simple. I like.
Oh, there must be plenty of them. Somebody invented the telephone. And somebody invented lasers. And somebody else invented PJs. I think there are lasers inside some telephones. And I know you can talk on the telephone in your PJs. But I don't think you can buy PJs with lasers inside.
Oh, I'm not sure about all that. I like lasers because lasers kill aliens from outer space. Oh, there must be plenty of them. When you say PJs, I think you mean pajamas. PJs are real super useful. That sounds like it's like the shortest I agree. PJs are real super useful.
Super useful. Snow plows are useful.
Damn it. All right. So wait, which one was this one? I like. And then, there must be plenty of laser PJs.
There must be plenty of them. Inventors, I mean. Not PJs with lasers inside. After all, somebody invented rocket ships. I wonder if rocket ships have sofas.
That's not right.
I sort of wish I hadn't said sofas. Sofas remind me of your Aunt Sophie. She was real fat and lazy, and she left big greasy sweat stains on our upholstery.
Easy there.
Aunt Sophie was my favorite aunt.
Hey!
Oh, that was right. Hey!
Hey!
Hey! I like that little guy. Is that it? Yay, we are free from the conversation. I have completed the conversation.
You make me dizzy, Daisy Dee.
Dizzy, dizzy, Daisy Dee.
You say the...
All right, quiet. Okay. Oh. Yeah. Wonder what I do with the hay. Could you tell me what I do with this delicious hay? Dung! Of course. What else would you get? Oh, your food's arrived, sir.
Cows, oh cows. I love cows. They make cheese.
Among other things.
Super with apple pie, don't you?
Oh, it's not over yet. It's not over yet. Okay. We need to get her food, of course. I like cheese.
I like cheese.
It's true.
It's nifty.
Nifty?
Cheese tastes almost as good as peanut butter. Only peanut butter is light brown.
Damn. Meows, oh meows, my dog had fleas. Cheese comes from milk.
Cheese comes from milk. Some cheese is orange, but I like the cheese that's white. Some cows are white. I've never seen an orange cow.
That sounded dumb enough. Okay. Yeah. See, none of these other two make no sense. My dog had fleas or meows, oh meows. I want to be
Meows, oh meows. That was the name of my cat. He was a pie-eating cat. He ate pies all the time.
That was the right one.
Pies, say pies. Wow, that's swell.
I just wanted to hear him talk about cats.
I saw a movie about a cat who fell off a surfboard and swam to Hawaii.
Oh. Well, yeah, of course. Thighs. Hey, thighs. I think we should go to Hawaii and look at volcanoes. Doho lives in Hawaii. Waikiki sounds pretty silly to me. And somebody's been sleeping in my bed. Yes, yes, it's Monty Python. It's been a full day of Monty Python. I don't know. Waikiki sounds pretty silly to me.
Sounds pretty silly to me. So does uvula. Uvula's a super funny word.
Okay, fine. Meows. We should go to Hawaii and look at volcanoes.
We should go to Hawaii and look at the volcanoes. Volcanoes have coconuts. But hot lava can really burn you up. Meow.
Thighs?
Thighs. Hey, thighs. Hawaiians have real strong thighs. And they love word games. Say, let's play a word game. That would be great fun.
It was thighs, of course.
And oodles. Go first. I'm thinking of a word that begins with K. It's a marsupial.
Well, wait, I can't do the right answer because the right answer is wrong. Marsupials are a kind of animal.
Marsupials are a kind of animal. They're real handy to have around the house because they can use pliers. They can fix things.
No, okay. Maybe it is the right answer. Is the right answer the right answer?
Kangaroo. I'm thinking of a famous singer whose first name is Tom, and his last name is Jones. Oh, I think I just gave my answer away.
Yep, the right answer is wrong. Of course the right answer is wrong, because... J sounds like the letter K.
The letter J sounds like the letter K. But I don't think that J is a marsupial. So it must be something besides J. Maybe L.
There's no logic here. There's absolutely no logic here. But poodles and oodles.
Poodles and poodles.
It's the stupidest.
Yeah. Hey, that game was a really good time.
Right. It's the stupidest answer. It's the stupidest one.
I think a great thing would be to reminisce about our fantastic courtship.
All right. Our courtship was great. I remember lots about that. Or corn chips are tasty. Or corn chips are tasty. Well, corn chips are tasty.
Are super tasty. I like to crunch them with a sandwich and an apple. I think that's a pretty good lunch. Corn chips, a sandwich, and an apple.
Boo. Yep. I could hear that one coming. Okay.
On our first date, we had ham. It was tasty. Ham contains nitrates. That's a preservative. I read about that in Reader's Digest.
Yep, it's the stupidest one. It's got to be the stupidest one.
You smarty smarty. You're smarter than smart. I know. We could talk about how smart you are.
It is. It's the corny is another way. It's the corniest. All right, so... I would rather talk about...
Oh, farty farty. Oh, boy, that creeped up on me super unexpected.
No.
My face sure is red. Remember your mother? Her face was all red and blotchy.
Is that right?
Just looking at her made me sick. And she smelled pretty bad, too. Wow, what a big, smelly, blotchy-faced pig she was.
Marvin!
Rats!
Yeah, that's no big deal. The copyright thing. Okay. Apparently.
Some strangers say super startling surprises are scary. That big rat falling from nowhere sure was a surprise. I love surprises, don't you?
We're not done yet. All right. I like birthday cakes.
I like birthday cakes. They taste sweet and yummy.
and the candles are funny when they're on fire.
All right, fine. Yeah, that's no big deal. But right now I'm more worried about this particular video and what happens to it, because there are clips of the Monty Python movie in this one. And so, I'm not sure how that's gonna play out, but we'll find out afterwards. You know, it's like there's not a lot of ad revenue anyway, so... yeah, no worries, my friend. So, anyways. Surprises are nifty. Surprises seem swell. Rats aren't reptiles! That's the stupidest one. We gotta go for the stupidest one and narrow in.
I'm sure that rats are something else. Rats like to nibble, and nibble all day long.
Nope. Surprises
sure,
seem swell.
Surprises sometimes seem swell, but that surprise was too scary. I like surprises that are warm and fuzzy. Sweaters are a nice surprise.
Sweaters are
there we go, we found it.
September to springtime. You've got lots of sweaters. Some are cardigan, some are pullover, some are acrylic. And some are wool.
I don't think acrylic is a brush. Some seem small and super stretchy on my stomach. I have some jackets. Wool comes from sheep. Some acrylic are wool. Wool comes from sheep is a stupid one. What is the stupidest answer? But nice. Also really nice. Wool comes... I mean, this seems like innocent. This is... we gotta be innocent and dumb. Innocently dumb. Don't think... these are all stupid. These are all... I have some jackets. Wool comes from sheep, but I don't think acrylic is a brush. We're gonna go with this one. It seems too complex, though.
Say, speaking of surprises, how about the time you got the gout? That wasn't a sweater, but it sure was a surprise.
Great!
I nailed it!
Goiters are goofier than gout. They're funny. I sat next to a person with a goiter on an airplane once, and I told him it was swell. Remember?
Hello there, Bam Bam Android. Welcome back. As, I recognize your icon there. Great gargantuan goiters are goofier than gout. They're funny, I said... sat next to a person with a goiter on an airplane and told him it was swell. gosh, goiters are gooshy and gross. that's more G words if we want to stick with alliteration. Raja, that's you're Raja. Good to see you, Raja. Well, if we want to stick with the alliteration theme, gosh, goiters are gooshy and gross is there. Swell and silly is agreeing. We were flying to Miami, is the airheaded thing. Goiters are super funny, alright. Also sounds like... I kind of am confused here. I want to hear this one.
Goiters are gooshy and gross. I don't think I like them very much. Although they're not as bad as the time I ran over Mr. Yippie, our pet chihuahua. He died, and that made me sad.
That was the right one?
So let's think happy thoughts.
I thought that was wrong. I just wanted to hear the alliteration.
Sometimes if you're real lucky, a super happy thought will just sneak up and surprise you.
Yeah.
Like a really great commercial on TV.
A good I usually hate most TV commercials because TV commercials are trying to psychologically manipulate you. And that annoys me. It's like a lot of times, most of them, occasionally there's like a funny TV commercial, but a lot of them are, you know, annoying, or whatever. Peter picked a pepper, pick a pickled peppers, hoo hoo ha ha, hilarious. Humor, you cheered me up, honey lamb. I like commercials. This sounds just like stupid.
Hoo hoo ha ha, hilarious. Hilarious humor. Your funny words sneak up on me, Lamb Chop, and they make me happy. I'm really glad we're having this conversation.
Yep, I nailed it. It's stupid.
Conversations can cause confusion or constructiveness. I'm glad our conversation is going so super great. I wonder if it's supposed to keep going.
How about if we stop talking now? Can't completely conclude this conversation. I think we should keep talking forever. I've got a good feeling this conversation will never end.
I've got a super good feeling this conversation will never end.
Okay. That was me. I'm sorry. That was angry talk. We gotta calm down. I think we should keep talking forever.
I think we should keep talking forever.
I like raccoons. Raccoons, you know, they're very intelligent and everything. So, I don't think a raccoon's an entirely bad pet. Although, you know, obviously there's some difficulties with animals that could be potentially, I don't know. It depends on how wild it is or whatnot, but, or untraditional pets. There are certain, difficulties associated with untraditional pets, but, I don't think raccoons are the worst decision for a pet, as long as you're willing to handle the difficulties that come with an untraditional pet, that's all. But, anyways. Well, that's good, yeah. I don't think, as far as I know, that, yeah, there's nothing wrong with having a raccoon as a pet. They sound delightful. They're very, you know, they got the little hands. They're kind of like people, you know? and they seem intelligent. You know, they seem like very intelligent creatures, so I'm sure they'd make great pets. anyways. So I hope that goes over well. I wish you and your pet raccoon well, and that sounds amazingly cute. Conversations can cause confusion or constructiveness. I'm glad our conversation is going so great. I wonder if it's supposed to keep going. Right. I think we should keep talking forever. How about if we stop talking now? Alliteration?
Can't completely conclude this conversation because I have more things to say. Like, I'm struck by a funny memory of your father. He had way too much hair growing out of his armpits. And his nose was full of creepy mucus.
He was my daddy.
Damn!
Okay, a damn. yeah, rabies is definitely a concern. And he had cute eyes like anime, or looked like Rocket from Guardians of the Galaxy. That's cute sounding. Okay, we're not gonna feed her, we're just gonna grow something for him. Okay.
Ooh, a sprig of dill.
Dill. I like dill. Of course, maybe not that particular sprig of it, but, you know, dill's a nice...
I'm all talked out. Let's eat.
Oh, Marvin, I think that's a super great idea.
All right, so we got a piece of dill. Ah, he got the full round of shots. Good news. Or, yeah, good deal. Alright, let's see if we can figure out fighting each other. Which of the following would you least embarrassed to have growing out of your nostrils? Poultry, grains, fish, low-salt snack foods coming out of my nose? Least embarrassed. Well, I mean, it's like, I guess snack foods would be kind of... I either say grains or, you know, like amber waves of grain, right? You know? It's like American. That's an American nostril extrusion.
Today we're gonna do marching up!
Marching up and down the square. You wanted an item. I'm supposed to give it to you. I'm supposed to earn an item from somewhere. Don't know where to get it, but it's somewhere along here.
Good.
Maybe I didn't do the shooting gallery enough? I don't think I messed with this cannon. I remember what the cannon did. Let's give the shooting gallery another go. Like, where's the score? Is there a score? What's the point of the shooting gallery? Because, like, I shot a lot of target. Maybe I wasn't shooting them well enough, though. I get every single one. Damn you. Let's get every single one. Let's not miss anything. Then again, when they all pop up at the same time. They all pop up at the same time, that's kind of... You know, I'm starting to wonder if this is... Yeah, this is not... This is a thing, but it's not the thing I'm supposed to be doing, right? Shooting Napoleon and these guys over and over and over again. Give me something! Give me something to... stop it. Stop. Well, particularly when they're young, they're definitely very cute.
May God...
And if I click on this, it just shows us a video clip from the movie. Fighting each other. The pirates from that skit. You. That does another thing. I feel like there's somewhere else I'm supposed to be able to go. That I'm not going. Well, you know what? I'm gonna give that one another mulligan and go somewhere else. Farrier garbage eating cat. He's like a cat, and he walked on your keyboard. I saw there too. Yeah, it made you mess up your typing.
Transplants.
Live organ transplants. Now we're talking.
I'll get it.
This is a pretty good. This is a, you remember that stage of life.
Yes. Hello.
Just a typical stage of life. Live organ transplants. Oh, this is pretty. It's and live organ music. That's actually from the earlier Monty Pythons. That wasn't in the. Hi. It's not in the. That's not in the Meaning of Life. That's the Monty Python show.
Welcome, contestants.
Oh.
Kids, pull out your mom and the family pooch and get ready, because once again it's time to play Doctor. As you begin.
Live organ. Transplants. Oh.
Yes, sir. I see you're ready to go, so let's get right to it. Tonight's patient is a friendly fellow with an organ donor's card in his wallet. So let's have a big round of applause, please, for Mr. Edgar Free Samples.
But I'm using it.
Isn't he just a kick in the balls? The game clock starts as soon as you pick a surgical instrument from the selection Janice has so helpfully laid out for you. For your incision, make sure you follow the dotted line on Mr. Free Sample's super-duper solar plexus. See if you can get inside before time runs out. Good luck, contestant, and happy cutting!
So is this going to be like those surgery games? Basically. I have a bunch of tools. It's a very early version of Surgeon Simulator, which is something actually I wouldn't mind playing because I never messed with that one, but I watched other people do it. Yes, definitely that's very much like a cat what you're describing is when when they stare at you. Cats are champion starers. They stare at you. Well, what my cat will do is she'll stare at me, and if I keep ignoring her... What? Oh, timer...
Well, please come back soon.
What?
Now, on behalf of Janice and myself, so long.
Did he die?
Thanks for playing
live organ transplants. I thought you said it was going to start up when I pick up a tool. I thought I had a moment. That was weird. I don't know. Am I still allowed to go? All right. Well, that was weird. My cat will stare at me, and her eyes will get wider and wider, and eventually she'll attack me if I keep ignoring her. It's like, don't ignore me. All right. I guess let's go with the, scalpel's a good choice, but I'm gonna go with this. All right, now it started. Let's go with a scythe. Scythe him open.
Would be if you were performing an appendectomy. Oh, am I right?
Right!
Sorry,
right.
The appendix is not the organ we're after. Looks like you'll have to try again.
All right, give me this tool then. Sorry. This is not the best tool. Oh, that's not the right tool. I should have stuck with the first thing because I couldn't tell what my cursor was. I apologize. That tool's hard to use. All right, sorry.
Crikey, what a mess.
Yes! And what a corpse! Uh-oh, I don't see any organs. That's a darn shame, contestant, but if you want to try again, just pick up a tool and the clock will start all over.
Okay. Let's go with the axe.
Well, looks to me like we got a live...
The axe isn't so bad, because you can tell exactly where your cursor is. I couldn't tell exactly where my pointer tip was with that, with the saw. Oh, sorry, buddy. Okay, apparently it's not completely clear. Just hacking away. Of course, you can't tell exactly where it is.
Wow, now that is one great gash. Unfortunately, the man we pay £4 to draw the lines on the patient has got it wrong again. You'll have to make another cut, dearie.
Easy there, buddy. It's okay. The woodsman's got you. What kind of line is this? What kind of incision am I making here? I'm making a spiral? What a dick am I? What am I of a jerk? We got it. We're just gonna spiral cut. It's like a spiral ham. That's what you're like, my friend. Okay, worry. Worry a lot. I'm worried. Oh no, it was right at the end, damn it! Oh god. Oh god, no. Damn it, I was right at the end. I was right at the end and I screwed it up.
Whoops! There goes your bright future at the abattoir. That's a duck.
Let's try the pliers.
I know you can do it, contestant.
I know, we can do it.
Believe in you.
Yes, believe in me. Snip, snip. Snip, snip, snip. Yeah, now these are easy to use. You just snip the man up. Yeah, you can tell exactly where your cursor is. Oh god, this is so much easier than an axe. You know, right tool for the right job. That's these snippy doos. Are these like hedge clippers? I don't know. And yes, basically I'm making a Dreamcast logo. It's the Rasengan. Because I am Naruto. Or, what was it? Like, I think there was like a petroglyph in Shivers 2 that this kind of reminds me of too. But the Dreamcast works.
Just look.
Yeah, I was so close.
Such form, such skill. Clearly, the incision wasn't challenging enough for you, was it?
What?
Here, try this one.
Not challenging enough, you say? All right, well we're going chainsaw on this one. It's just temporary. Okay, I can't see where I am because of the blood. Damn it! Why'd the blood have to go there? Okay, chainsaw is the perfect tool for this situation. Don't let anyone fool you.
Ouch! I'm afraid he's dead now.
That was... Oh.
His organs are still inside him. That's a darn
Shut up. Let's go drill.
Drill.
Yeah, the drill's pretty precise, because you can tell where your cursor is. That's my main problem, is I can't tell where my cursor is with some of the tools. What am I drawing this time? I'm just drawing. This is not an incision anymore. Are we drawing a penguin? Are we drawing a penguin? What am I doing? Out. Sorry. Here, just let me finish the details of this. It's a lot of fine detail. It's a frickin' penguin! This is no longer live organ transplants. I'm just having fun with it, you know? It's art.
That's it! You've done it! What a sweet, sweet slash down the belly. You make it look as easy as cutting up a kidney pie. Get it? Kidney pie?
Yeah.
Now here's one that'll start you sweating.
Jackhammer. Pretty similar to the last one, but... So basically a lower sound. Yeah, we'll have this taken care of in a minute, sir. No problems. Alright, so that's the mustache. Easy there, buddy. We got this. That's an, yep, it is a face. That is a face. We're drawing a goddamn face. Because why not? It's Mr. Gumby, isn't it? It's Mr. Gumby. I'm just gonna draw Mr. Sorry, buddy. Sorry. Easy now. Do I have to finish the glasses? Does it have to be so detailed? Oh, is that the final one? That. What? They're already gone.
Oh dear. Well, I don't think any of us were expecting this. Not exactly. So, yes. Ha ha ha. I see by the clock on the wall that we're out of time. So that's it. Thanks very much on behalf of Janice and myself. So long. Safe driving, and thanks for playing.
Live organ transplants. Yeah, no, it wasn't quite. Yeah, it's not quite Hitler or Kittler, as he said. Mr. Gumby. Mr. Gumby is the stupid character. He's like, oh, I'm real stupid, kind of. He's always speaking high and yelling. Kind of character, which, I don't know. He's always saying really dumb things like, what was it? Like, smashing two bricks together for peace or something, or a lot of the things. My brain hurts. He was the My Brain Hurts skit. So what's in here? You are the substitute scoutmaster for Troop Happy. Three cheers for Troop Happy, as they have all earned their wilderness and survival merit badges. Good for them. It's time for a reward. Ah, you've got it. You pile them all into your van and drive them to camp out at Sexy Mama's House of Love, Friendly Eddie's Naked Hunk Retreat, Las Vegas or Disney World. Obviously, Sexy Mama's House of Love. The wholesome choice. The wholesome choice. The correct choice.
Well, dead by the terms of the car. Before he donates his liver.
Well, I told him that, but he never listens to me. Silly man. Typical of him. He goes down to the public library, sees a few signs up, comes home all full of good intentions.
Of course, Disney World would be the expected answer.
Something? What is it? Ethiopian? Canadian? Ah, stockbroker.
I am the pancreas, the queen of tummy meats.
Okay.
Oh, thanks. I couldn't get that.
Not what I intended to do, but sure, you're welcome.
Someday, somewhere, some little girl or boy is going to need an emergency salami transplant. And when that day arrives, I'll be ready to give up my life so that they may live instead. Well, unless someone eats me first.
Well, I'll wipe this nose nugget off on you, because...
You may find that you suffer for some time a totally irrational feeling of depression. So, it's lots of happy pills for you.
Oh, he's gonna say, hello, cursor. What happened to my cursor? Speaking of which... What should I call that? Oh. Organs. Okay.
Oh, no, it's not.
Oh, that's back where I came, right? Your sister Betty has got a terrible mysterious rash. You strike it and strike it with a switch of raspberry bramble, but that does no good based upon your feelings about standard medical practices versus the power of the mind to heal the body. You send for the vegetarian, soak her with the garden hose, rub her with nose ointment, or cuddle up and stroke her belly. That's my sister. Good thing I don't have a sister, I guess, but, I guess, the... Send for the veterinarian. Did I say vegetarian? Send for the vegetarian veterinarian. Yeah. All right. So we're going back out, but I get another question. Don't stop to think. You spend your day killing nice people. To balance things out, you spend your day, your nights killing mean people. Unfortunately, you lose count of how many people you've killed altogether, never mind how many were nice or mean. So you kill yourself, but you're confused because you think you were a mean person. You think you were a mean person, but what if you were nice and you kill someone you... So, and who do you kill to even so even that out? So you decide that if you're reincarnated, you'll make up for it by coming back as an angry, vicious... patron of the fire ants. Heart surgeon. Flood volunteer and blood donor, or angry, vicious policeman. Well, that'd just be par for the course. These days. Alright, well, that's not as... angry, vicious heart surgeon. Angry, vicious blood donor. Yeah, heart surgeon. That's like...
You're not doctors, then?
Oh, blimey, no.
You're not...
Okay. This is like,
Yes, I'm in here, waiting ever so patiently to be released.
Okay. So, can I release you? Nope. The guy who sings the... one of the songs from the game is over... or, I mean, the movie's over there.
I love it here, darling.
Me too.
I'm supposed to get an item and shove it in that guy's body. I can see that now. But where do I get the item? Like, from over here, right? It's not you.
Has anyone seen my hat?
It's not you.
Hey.
It's not that. It's not you.
Honey, I was wondering,
Oh.
Well, you know, what you was thinking of doing after that. I mean, would you stay on your own? Or is there,
I'm too old for that sort of thing. I'm past my prime.
Sure. Can we have your liver then?
No, I'd be scared.
All right. I'll tell you what. Listen to this.
Okay, when there we go.
Get you down, Mrs. Brown? And things seem hard or tough?
All right, we know this routine.
It feels so sort of insignificant, doesn't it?
Yeah. Can we have your liver then?
All right, you talk me into it.
Okay, then we get the liver. Just rips her right open, the hand of God. Ooh. Liver. A person's liver. Alright, so do I put this in the other dude, or what? Because it looked like he had, like, a hookup. Like a gas hookup in his body. For, like, okay.
You call this...
Wait, do I put something in here, or do I take something from here? I think I put something in here. Do I put the body part out here? Just that makes no sense. Liver? No. Spam!
This galaxy.
Wait.
You call this a nebula? Milky Way, my ass.
Okay. Milky Way, my ass. You call this a galaxy. Alright, let's go. Alright, so I got a liver. I mean, we could try it in here. It's your big chance to make your mother very, very disappointed in you. You join the Communist Party, build weapons for a Middle Eastern dictator, give money to the Church of Scientology, or sleep with a communist member of the Church of Scientology. They didn't like the Church of Scientology. You know, it's like, it's kind of, yeah, give money to the Church of Scientology. Spam. Yes, indeed. Nope, that does work. Okay. And then we get a what? Oh. But it said an ass... Okay, yeah, and then we take the vacuum cleaner and we suck up the universe, apparently. Because it said Astro... Spam? Because there was spam out there? Yes. I mean, the Monty Python started the whole spam thing for, like, the chat, so... you know, spamming the chat, it would be kind of appropriate. It would be an appropriate tribute for this game, I would say. But, you know, not excessively. But, well, saying spam, I guess, would be appropriate. Saying spam, yeah, exactly. Your son has brought home his fiancée, a big, hairy sailor from the Greek Navy. Despite the man's lack of decent English and grammar skills, you tell your son as long as Zorbo makes him happy, he's welcome in the family. But mark my words, you then whisper to your son, Zorbo will never make you happy unless he is intensely witty, extremely nice, ethereally beautiful, astoundingly intelligent. Well, I mean, witty and intelligence, aren't they kind of the same? But I think astoundingly intelligent, or maybe extremely nice. Yeah, we're gonna say extremely nice. That's actually probably the most important quality to making someone happy in life, I would say. There, Zorbo. You make my son happy, Zorbo, there. Okay. Am I cleaning this all up? Yeah, okay, we got it all. Now we suck up the whole thing. There we go. Alright. And behind that is...
an onion!
An onion! All that other stuff was just garbage for the onion. I mean... you know. Okay, so now... the autumn years. And I'll just figure out what the heck the other part was later. The autumn years.
The meaning of life, part six.
Six.
The autumn years.
Alright, skip the cutscene because it doesn't work anyways, it's broken. Alright, and you can just watch the film if you want to see that.
I have the lot.
Okay. I see. It's like a... it's a balancing game. Okay. So I just did two triangles. A circle is heavier than a triangle.
I hope Monsieur was not overdoing it last night.
Okay, so... I can do a triangle, and it leans it. So I can do another triangle, it evens it out. Then I do a square... that pushes it pretty far, too. Is a square heavier than a triangle?
Two green olives, stuffed with red pimento, then spectacularly arranged on either side of a single...
That's fine. Yeah, triangles are probably the weakest one, I guess, right? Yeah. Okay, a few triangles. Oh, there's a square, and then there's like a trapezoid.
It could...
shut up! Okay, so a square... it's pretty heavy. Okay. I'll do a triangle on this side. Trapezoids are heavy duty. Okay. Trapezoids are heavy duty. Okay, so I'll lean it over. Then a circle. Then a square. Then a triangle. So I can do a circle. Then I can do this trapezoid. Then I can do this circle. Then I can do... this triangle, shut up, this triangle, and then this triangle, and this circle, yeesh, square, triangle, triangle, square, triangle, the trapezoids are too heavy, I thought I could risk a trapezoid if I was, the trapezoids are the heaviest duty, damn it, I was so close, alright. You can get away with the others if it's leaning slightly, but not that type. Okay. Lean it this way. So we can do a square. I messed up again. Gotta plan ahead for those trapezoids. Okay, so. Circle. Square. Triangle. Alright. So I'll do a circle, and then it's barely hanging on for the trapezoid, who's barely hanging on, so we can do another circle, and then, shut up, do triangle on this side, triangle on this side, triangle on this side, circle, square, square, alright, trapezoid's coming up. Okay, so, let's see, I'm not sure how far I can push it. Triangle on this side, triangle on this side. Square on this side, oop, barely. Okay, yeah, I think we got this now. Alright, shut up. Finally. Okay.
And finally, monsieur, a wafer thin.
A wafer thin mint.
I couldn't eat another thing. I'm absolutely stuffed.
It's only a
wafer thin mint.
No, fuck off. I'm full.
Skip the cutscene. And then he explodes. Of course, if you know the skit, it makes him explode. It's gruesome.
Ooh, gelatin.
Just a pile of gelatin sitting there. That's it? That was a fast one. That was a fast section. And death. Then we gotta finish up fighting each other. Still don't know what was wrong with fighting each other. I gotta figure out what the deal with fighting each other is.
The meaning of life, part 7.
Part 7. Death.
It's no good. I just can't go on. I'm no good anymore. I want to end it all. Goodbye. Goodbye.
Oh my God. Oh no.
And of course. The dying leaves is a metaphor for death.
Mommy!
Mom, where are you?
Daddy! Mommy! Mommy!
Mommy!
What are you doing? There we go. That's what I was waiting for.
Freed at last from his confining sheath of leaves, Elmer reveled in his nakedness. He spread his limbs with abandon and smiled rapturously as the breeze passed through his private parts, and his squirrel hole gaped in all its glory for the whole wide world to admire. Freed at last.
Okay.
So, the man starts by entering or...
Okay.
I'm talking...
Hi.
Oh, those dead people, they...
Did I go over here? Over there? Where do I go?
So!
Get ya.
I'm so lonely.
Okay, the thing is death. Death is here. I remember the skit was like he goes over to this house. I'm having trouble getting started here.
I'm taller than the rest of you, and I can see all the way to the crematorium. So blow it out your asses, you measly mini-monuments. I'm the most important.
Well, that certainly is interesting.
Freedom.
I'm so low. Hi.
Oh, those dead people.
Hi.
I feel like I'm off course here. Am I supposed to get dead death to move? I feel like there's something very basic. Death. It's your time to shine, my friend. Death. This is your day. Your chapter. Okay. Yes. Clearly something that I'm not clicking on. Or not clicking on enough. Maybe I click on the limbs. No.
So, the man starts.
Yeah, it's a crypt. Or did I have an item? Of course I don't have an item, not yet. Alright, shut up. I feel like I'm putting the cart before the horse, but the end game is to get death over here and into this house and to mess with the people that are inside. You gotta kill the people inside, death. Go. Go and murder. I mean, take the souls. Reap the souls that have rightfully ended, reached the end of their lifespan. He doesn't actually kill people. He just sort of facilitates the whole business.
Hi.
Get in there and facilitate that business.
Get ya. Get ya. Stinking vein fills up.
Okay. Like, they started pointing me at this thing, so it's like you'd think that that's where I would start to do things with, but... That's death. Yeah, okay. Do something with you? I feel like you're supposed to move. I'm supposed to get you to move. Over here. Over to this area. There's just... Wait. Why is that up? Okay, oh. No? It was just in the up in the air for a while. Okay. That was just an error, because I was holding it off to the edge. Okay. Well, if I can't figure this out, maybe I should have another go at the military, I guess. This is almost making me want to get an FAQ. Wait.
Ooh, fishy.
Why? Why did you start doing that suddenly? What? Okay. I just had to click on a different part of death. Maybe I should have watched that, because I thought... Okay, well, go. We got there. I don't... Yeah, search me what happened. You are giddy with pride as you bring the new love of your life home to meet your parents. You rush to the kitchen after dinner to ask them what they think. They're very pleased. Then your worst fear comes true as the three of you return to the living room and discover your sweet companion secretly making love to the sofa, dog milking, spying for the Iranians, or drinking industrial cleanser. Why? Why am I making this choice? Just go ahead and drink the... I was gonna say drink the industrial cleaner, but yes, she's spying for the Iranians. Sure. I am Iranian spy. So tell me how nuclear reactors work. It sounds like a Russian spy. Why? Hey, Death.
And these are the Portland Smythes, Jeremy and Fiona.
Good evening.
This is Mr. Death. Mr. Death is a Reaper.
The Grim Reaper. I am the Grim Reaper.
They made a pretty good Reaper, I must say. I forgot how kind of cool looking he was.
Well, that's cast rather a gloom over the evening, hasn't it? Don't see it that way, Jeff. Let me tell you what I think we're dealing with here. A potentially positive learning experience that can...
Shut up! Shut up, you American. You always talk, you Americans. You talk and you talk and you say, let me tell you something and I just want to say this. Well, shut up!
Well, yeah, actually, I do talk a lot, though, but there's no reason to say, let me tell you something. You should just get on with it.
Silence! I have come for you. Now the time has come.
You mean to
take you away? That is my purpose. I am death.
Now look here. You barge in here quite uninvited. Well, I would remind you that you are a guest in this house.
Quiet. Englishman, you're all so fucking pompous. None of you have got any balls. I am death.
He's a bit more of an insult comic. Yeah, you prefer Discworld. I was just thinking about the contrast between this one and Discworld Death. This guy's a bit more of the insult death, the insult comic version of death. Whereas, Discworld Death, Discworld Death was, you know, he was a bit more comforting. He was still intimidating, but he tried to tell a few jokes every once in a while. Alright, so what do we do now? Oh, yep. We seem to have reached an impasse.
And spotteth twice.
There's a comedy solution to this issue. You're not it, though. No. Yeah, shut up. Shut up!
One day, my mother, she put me on her knee and she said to me, Gaston, my son, the world is a beautiful place. You must go into it and love everyone.
Okay. Oh, no. Okay, or we just leave. Oh. I don't have salmon. I don't have salmon. Damn. I can't make the salmon mousse without salmon. We gotta make the salmon mousse. Okay. That's what we've been doing. We've been making the salmon mousse to kill everyone. So we need to go back and fight each other. In order to get the ingredient we need for the salmon mousse. You are Great Britain's very first Prime Minister born without a body. Oh, and, the Discworld Death, I was reading that comment earlier, but I didn't want to interrupt what they were saying. He takes care of bees, and, you know, he likes his family and all that junk. And, he's, like, an interesting character. He has, like, Albert and all that stuff. He's like a fully... Death becomes a fully fleshed-out character. Just Terry Pratchett has given him so much backstory. He's not just Death. He's, like... He's a person. He's really personified. Yes. And likes a good curry and kitties, among other things. So, yeah. Definitely. Anyways, the House of Commons, wanting to play a good joke on you, tosses you into a room with a beaver and heat, two cobras, a naughty little boy, and a telephone with access to the American president of Washington, D.C. Well, needless to say, you were terrified, but fortunately, the British people voted you into office for this on the strength of your brains, which you use now to... Wait. Let someone decide. Call the president. Try to convince the little boy to surrender to you. Well, I mean, not surrender, but maybe you could help, or maybe I should see what happens, because, I mean... Let's just see what happens. Alright, anyways. So that's weird. Alright, once again, this is just gonna shoot my face and I have to wipe this off and look at... Was it something different? Donate your organs for the good of your country. It's a man's life in the army. See your local recruiter for details. Okay, I don't think the answer's over here, getting shot in the face time and time again. But at least it's something new. It's a new experience. Okay, and once again, meaning of life available on video cassette. Okay, very nice. That's great. Good for you, Universal. Can we get this off our screen now? Get this off my screen. Right. Isn't that enough now? Thank you. Alright, enough of you. Is there any other territory? Don't click on the cannon. Angry Zulu warriors. You're looking for a fish. That's a shooting gallery. You talk about that. There's three angels that I shoot. You're that dude with the lady. This is the pirates. We've clicked on all the clickables. Right? Did I not watch the movie properly? Show me that movie. Yeah, I click on the thing, it shows the movie. I gotta give you something. The thing that I don't have. What have I not to give you? And where get the thing I... Right, he talks about God, though. He talks about the hand of God. So does it have something to do with you? Because I remember... I feel like it has something to do with you.
Now! Everybody else, quite content to join in? Now!
I am rather confused. I want to keep playing this. I don't want to stop right now. So what I'm going to do is I've been stuck in this too long. I'm actually going to break down and use an FAQ for this one tiny step. Just because I hate being stuck this long. Click on tents. Oh. Wait. Oh, I can go in there? That's all I need. Okay, there it is. Thank you very much. Close that. I don't need to see anything else. You click on this, even angrier Zulu warriors, and you click on that and you go to the Zulu warriors. I thought that was just a weird clicky. There was so many weird clicky things. Okay, fine. Yep. All life on Earth is about to be wiped out. Unfortunately, that includes you. Sorry. No, stop crying. Instead, go preserve some DNA. Hurry, if you were lucky. A spaceship full of wise aliens will visit Earth long after we're gone and use the genetic material to repopulate the planet. You think long and hard and decide that the world's future would best be served if you save the DNA from a fun-loving baby dolphin, ruthless Asian despot, pile of droppings from a very smart scientist, or, you know, the dolphin. Alright, thank God I looked that up, because I was going to take forever to figure that one out. I just didn't get it. Alright. I just didn't get it.
Sorry about the mess.
We showed him, didn't we, sir?
I'm afraid Perkins got rather badly bitten during the night.
The skit.
Ah, morning, Perkins.
Morning, sir.
What's all the trouble then?
Bitten, sir, during the night.
Whole leg gone, eh?
Yes. Stings a bit.
Any idea how it happened?
None whatsoever. Complete mystery to me. Woke up just now. One sock too many.
That was weird.
Yes, a real beauty, isn't it?
Well, we sent for the doctor.
Morning. I came as fast as I could. Is something up?
Yes, sir. So during the night, old Perkins got his leg bitten sort of off.
Been in the wars, have we?
Yes.
Well, let's have a look at this one leg of yours, then, eh?
Oh, good.
Pokes
yes,
it.
Yes, well, this is nothing to worry about. Probably a virus.
The virus, yes.
Oh, good.
By Jove! That's enormous!
You don't think it'll come back, do you?
Yeah, there's a lot of it about.
Oh, righto.
It's right as rain in a couple of days.
Thanks for the reassurance, Doc.
If you're playing football or anything, try and favor the other leg.
So it'll just grow back again then, will it?
I think I'd better come clean with you about this. It's not a virus, I'm afraid. You see, a virus is what we doctors call very, very small. So small it could not possibly have made off with a whole leg.
What we're looking for here is, I think, and this is no more than educated guess, I'd like to make that clear, is some multicellular life form with stripes, huge, razor-sharp teeth, about 11 foot long, and of the genus Felis horribilis. What we doctors, in fact, call a tiger.
A tiger?
Any headache? Bowels all right? Jolly good.
Sir, the attack's over, sir.
Oh, jolly good.
Quite a lot of casualties there, sir.
Yes, well, the thing is, Sergeant, I've got a bit of a problem here. One of the officers has lost a leg. The MO says we can stitch it back on if we can find it immediately.
Right, sir. Oh, I'll organise a party right away, sir.
Well, it's hardly the time for that, is it, Sergeant?
A search party.
That's a better idea. Oh, hardly worth it, is it?
Oh, yes, better safe than sorry.
Okay, so now I gotta give something to him. Like, another leg. It's gotta be, something made off with his leg without him noticing. He must be a really, really deep sleeper, or he got drunk. Or something. Or the tiger was using painkillers or something, I don't know.
Oh, sorry.
Don't care right now. Okay. Oh, yes, yes. Great. Jolly good fun. Alright, where item get I now?
Ashes to ashes.
Yeah, definitely. Alright, is there like another place I go? Yep, another place I go. Okay. We're getting to the tiger. You visit a foreign land. A woman steps up to you, a man if you're a woman, and offers you all the physical pleasures you can imagine. Unless you're not of that variety, and then the other way around if you wish, I guess. The only problem is he or she is not exactly your type. He or she says, no, the problem, pick... no problem, pick one of my four friends. Using your limited knowledge of the local dialect, the one you ask for is... You ask for the one who is more, less, mostly Moroccan, spicy. So I'm supposed to imagine a person who isn't exactly my type, and the person who is more or less spicy.
My God, it's huge!
Scenic route, massacre 5 kilometers.
Don't shoot, we're not a tiger.
Why are you dressed as a tiger?
We are dressed as a tiger because he had an auntie who did it in 1839, and this is the 50th anniversary. We found the tiger skin in a bicycle shop in Cairo. The owner wanted it taken down to Dar es Salaam.
Sword fighting with chairs.
We're dressed like this.
Well, they sound like a lively pair. Your brothers, I mean, if they're sword fighting with chairs.
Oh, why? 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 Oh, it's a lovely day today.
Okay, that was unnecessary.
We're on a mission for British intelligence. There's a pro-Tsarist Ashanti chief. No. Oh, we did it for a lark, part of a spree. High spirits, you know? Simple as that. Nothing more to it.
Okay, Is that all we... Okay, can we go back to the other side?
No, we're doing it for an advertisement. No, we're doing it for a bet. It's because we were thinking of training as taxidermists and we want to get the feel of it from the animal's point of view. To tell the truth, we are completely mad. We're inmates of a Bengali psychiatric institution and we escaped by making this skin out of old used cereal packets.
Okay, good enough.
Doesn't matter why they're dressed as a tiger, have they got my leg?
Good thinking. Well, have you?
Oh,
well, yeah, energetic can be nice if they're or fun if they're nice. If they're, I mean,
steal into someone's tent,
as long as they're nice, that's the main thing.
Tissue tight, them amputate a leg and run away with it. Search the thicket.
All right, search the thicket.
There it is. And I bought three. Two. This is the one I bought.
Oh, can I have the leg? Give me the leg. I need a leg, right? Okay, I'm supposed to be searching the thicket, right?
A wooden leg? No, a proper leg. Look, he was fast asleep.
Oh, never mind.
And someone or something came in and removed it.
Simple as that. Oh, why? Why? What?
Oh, leg. Actually, I think there is one in there somewhere. Somebody must have abandoned it. Somebody must have
There was a big bloody foot sale at Harrods. And I bought...
Oh, big bloody foot. That's not a leg. That's a big bloody foot. We need a whole leg.
That's just a pastry. Yes, just a pastry.
Okay. The hand of God.
Now that is not the hand of God.
Definitely not.
Maybe the hand of Moses.
Or is...
Can I have the hand? Yeah, the hand of God.
Hey, the hand of God. Wow.
Okay. We got the hand of God. Ooh.
Right, search the thicket.
I think that's what I came for. That's all.
I am the Grim.
Hi there.
That's a spare. We got it because there was...
Okay. Yeah, I think we're ready to go. Let's go. Let's go. If we need something else later, I know what I can do with the hand of God, that's for sure. Don't stop to think. Congratulations. You're the Minister of Strange Artwork and has... The Minister of Strange Artwork has decided that a portrait of you is going to be hung in the Royal Gallery of Confusing Nude Portraits, knowing full well that your confusing nude portrait will be hung next to Queen Elizabeth is the first confusing nude portrait. You decide on the most dignified, confusing nude portrait you can imagine. In short, the portrait will depict you standing in front of a mirror, cleaning out your cat's very smelly litter box, hiding in the closet pretending nobody was home, and chasing everyone away and telling them to work on their manners. Yeah, sure. That one. I don't know, the cat box might have been... You don't know, it seems pretty confusing. Chasing people away, though, that makes me seem really confusing and crazy. That's, like, a bit crazy, yeah. Okay. So saith Jesus, the Camembert Messiah. You finally embarked on your long-awaited automobile trip to visit the world-famous Synthetic Fabrics Manufacturers Hall of Fame. You pack a host of nutritious snacks. You've marked your route with a bright orange marker on the big highway map you keep unfolded in your lap for easy access. Your flashlight is loaded with brand new batteries just in case. Then disaster strikes. Your worst fear comes true as you realize your car is full of... visiting relatives, frightening hallucinations, cockroaches or wee-wee. Cockroaches would be just full, chock full. I've seen things that are chock full of cockroaches, and it doesn't get, it's not pretty.
That is why we'll always need an army, and may God strike me down were it to be otherwise.
God? Thank you. And there's a leg. Thank you very much.
Ooh, nice leg.
A nice leg. Oh, it's a nice leg. Oh, it's a he's getting a sexy leg. We're improving things. We're making the world a better place. That's what we're doing. You and your spouse just had your first child. You're a little reluctant to send out the birth announcement, though, as he seems to be a hedgehog. You think hedgehogs are stupid. You can't teach a hedgehog to ride a bicycle. You've never known a hedgehog to play catch or sit happily on your shoulders. I think a hedgehog would sit happily on your shoulders, giggling as it says, I love you. Oh, well, I mean, you're depressed and ashamed. You come up with a fantastic plan. You will make a costume for your child and tell everyone it's a chicken, cow, pig, a goat. You gotta go with the goats. I mean,
hello, and now your prize.
Salmon, right, of course. No, my prize. My prize, I'm sorry, my prize. Give me my prize. Thank you, sorry. Ooh.
Canned salmon.
Canned salmon. All right. Now it's time to make the salmon mousse and kill myself. Let's kill everyone at least. Then we'll be done with this chapter. That'll be a good place to kind of wrap it up. You are on your honeymoon and hope to warm up to your new spouse for a rousing night of sex. You already tried screeching look out and jumping aboard, but that didn't do the trick. The 1950s newsreel and proper oral hygiene didn't work either, and you decide against the marching band. In desperation, you settle on plan D, reverse psychology, and you do one thing that would turn you off completely if your spouse did it to you. You slowly begin undressing, I hope not, performing foreplay, posing in the nude. Really, all of these things would completely turn off me if my... Who did I marry? Well, I guess... How could any of these be bad? I guess the least... sure. Whatever. Posing, I guess. Maybe the kinky. What kind of kinky are we talking about? That's the thing. What kind of kinky? There's good kinky and there's bad kinky. Your country has been taken over by fascists. Their ruthless security, as known as the Gazpacho or Chilled Soup Police, have decreed that henceforth that all chilled soup will only be made in one of the following four flavors. You prepare to form a secret underground soup resistance until you learn, to your giant relief, that they chose bacon drippings, oat bran, celery, or lime jelly. Bacon drippings? We're not talking about bacon. We're talking about the drippings from, like, the cooking of bacon. Like, the bacon fat. Bacon fat soup? That is, I mean, bacon, yes. Dripping, no. Oat bran, eh. Celery. These are all bad choices. I guess I'll go with lime jelly, because, I mean, lime jello, it's not so bad. It's not so bad. So I guess drop these in, and then drop those in the thing. That's not it. What, is there a recipe or something? Are there settings on the thing? Well, I can, like... Well, I certainly screwed that up. I can put them directly in if I want, even.
Hey! Oh, you must be joking!
Well, I don't know what I'm supposed to do! Alright, is there instructions for Salmon Moose around here? Salmon Moose? Say, how do you make Salmon Moose? It seems like there's, like, a lot of combinations there. Can we keep going over here? Or... These make it yellow. I don't know what I'm doing. I don't think I'm just going to get there winging it, am I? This is basically what I did last time. He's going to say, nope, that's not it. Yeah. Okay, screw you. Okay, there's got to be a recipe or something somewhere.
And spot it.
One day.
Yeah. You say the same thing. Ideally, I'd like to make the salmon mousse before I leave.
I was just signing my name in, and the girl said to me, "How old are you?" And I...
Yeah, you're not going to tell me how to make salmon mousse. Salmon mousse. Well, I mean, is there gelatin in salmon mousse? Cream. Dill. Little bit confused here. Water, gelatin. Or do I combine them in other ways? That doesn't make much sense. I don't even know what I'm doing here.
That's not it.
Of course it's not it. I'm a little mystified. A little bit. Is there an order I add them? Seems like I'm gonna need a hint from somewhere, but where? You're quite likely the ugliest person ever to haunt the face of the earth. You smell rotten vegetables, and any time you stand still, you leave an oily stain on the ground that the hardest of acids cannot remove. Children scream in terror, and small pets expire at a mere glimpse of your shadow, but oh, what a happy pee-pee mood you're in. What a pee-pee peppy mood you're in, because you've got a secret admirer. You know, whoever this person turns out to be, they won't be perfect, but that's okay, as long as they turn out to be drunk, incredibly inbred, half-monkey, or criminal. That's okay, as long as they're a half-monkey. Half monkey. How could you half monkey girlfriend? Maybe the ugliest person in the world, but I've got a half monkey girlfriend. And that still sounds awkward. Criminal. Maybe I should have gone for criminal. It sounded funny. I went for the joke answer. On their mother's side, yes. Where would one find a recipe for salmon mousse? If I was somewhere else in the game. Growth and learning, fighting each other, middle age. Live organ transplant. The autumn years. Let's poke around middle age real quick and see if... Okay. You're annoyed that your boss entered your office unannounced and sat down on the edge of the desk to talk to you, trying to be tactful. You say, "Sir, I think you... must move your big fat ass off your desk." Yeah, there's no... I don't see a salmon mousse recipe slapped on the wall around here.
I'm all talked out.
Good. Alright. Maybe I missed something in the autumn years? Due to a radiation leak in the Oxford Dictionary, adverbs are about to become extinct. Pick one quickly to save and use in the future to describe the common alpine fir, how the common alpine fir reacts to seeing its own image on a convincing store security monitor. Cunningly, flirtingly, stupidly, submissively. Cunningly. We'll go with cunning. Okay.
No complaints.
It's just...
We went through this area pretty fast. They might know how to make salmon mousse. Anyone?
I'll have the lot.
Oh, no. Not doing that again. I'm perfectly fine with that.
Oh, yeah.
Okay, no hints about salmon mousse as far as I know. How does one make salmon mousse? Oh heavens, while you were napping, someone sneaked in and transformed you into the amazing XP-780X, a fantastic nuclear robot. You are programmed for goodness and kindness and creativity in the greenhouse. However, you are authorized to fire a lethal death ray at anyone attempting to steal one of your four possessions. You chose to protect your jewelry, expensive electronics, lovable pets, embarrassing letters from a secret lovable pets. I mean, if you had the other thing, maybe you would want to protect those, but obviously that's the joke answer. I mean, I could have gone with that one, but yeah, sure. I like the idea of firing a death laser to kill protect pets. I guess. I'm doing a crossword puzzle. The clue asks for a six-letter word starting with N, you, which means to take repeat little bites. I'm stumped. I ask you for help. You're rather vexed with me for sleeping with your best friend, so you tell me to go to hell, but I needed help, so you roll your eyes and say, fine, I'm sorry, all right. Is that good enough for you? At which you reconsider how angry you are with me and tell me the word you're looking for is... wait, what was it again? A six-letter word starting with the letter N. Well, I guess it'd be nibble, right? Yeah? Any of you know how to make a salmon mousse? Huh. I don't know. Should I just guess? I feel like there's like a lot of options when I guess. Just like add the water. Add the cream. Process the onion. Process the dill. Process the salmon. Process the gelatin. We'll see how that works.
Oh no, lad.
Okay. I'm not sure I'm gonna get there with guessing. It's a lot of options. We'll just add the cream in the water. It's like my last guess. Otherwise, I gotta find where the recipe is. You can put these things through the machines again. It's a little confusing.
Oh, nice going, stupid.
You bastard. You made me think I had it for a second. He really made me think I had it for a second. Hey there, I am Shy. Nice to see you again. I'm a little bit stumped on how to make salmon mousse. I could look this one up as well, potentially. But it's like the last thing. The last thing I need to do just before I'm stopping. Salmon mousse recipe. Salmon mousse recipe. Salmon mousse. Salmon mousse. I can put things in here. God, I'm so confused. I don't want to have to look this up, but I will if I have to. Cream salmon jelly. You know what? What the hey? It's like the last thing of the night. I just want to make more progress in this game. Tell me the answer, oh wise one. What was it? Oh, I might have been able to guess that one. Okay. It's very simple, it turns out. You just don't use these things. You don't use the things. You just put them in the bowl. Because if you process something, it's not going to kill them. You're trying to kill the people. The machines are completely... Okay, a red herring. Salmon mousse.
Dead now.
Dead? All of us?
All of you.
There we go.
How can we all have died at the same time?
The salmon moose.
I'm most dreadfully embarrassed.
Now the time has come. Follow. Follow me. Now.
That's supposed to be a salmon moose.
Moose.
Congratulations. We're all dead.
Yay, we're dead. Well, that's it. That was life. Now there's a bit more. Now we're at the next stage. The afterlife. There's the spiritual, the material, and the dental. So let's take a look at the dental world. Of course. Of course, the three things. Oh, please insert disc 2. We're on disc 2, everyone. This is a 2-disc game, and I gotta insert disc 2. It's like we've clearly made it halfway. It was one of these cool, CD cases with jewel cases with the two CDs. So, on to disc 2, because yes, I am playing these all right from the disc. We're gonna get a little feel of what we're gonna see in the future, and then we're gonna wrap things up. Alrighty then. There is a CD in the drive. Try again. It's there. It's there. Come on. Just detect it. Alright, it needs to spin up for a second. It's... I just put the disc in, I swear. Acknowledge the disc, I say. Sometimes it can be a little bit finicky about acknowledging the disc is there. Yes, I am still on, but, you know, we just made it to disc 2, so I'm gonna be wrapping things up very soon. But yes, I wanna get started, I wanna save it up. Okay, yes. Okay, fine, I'll save it. CD check, I'll save it here. But, why are you not detecting my CD? I put the CD in. I didn't put the CD in upside down or nothing stupid, did I? Now I got the right way around. Okay, it's just not detecting. It's just not detecting it. I have done stupid things like that before, like put it in upside down, but... Hello. Please stop being difficult, CD drive. Okay, it's just not responding now. That's good. Okay, well, it might actually be choosing to crash. I'm literally having to restart the... Yeah, Windows there. There we go. Why was it doing that? Why are you being difficult here, Windows? Open CD drive. Come on. There we go! Finally it detected the CD. Alright. Suppose. Just suppose you have sat through Kenneth Branagh's 5-hour adaptation of Emily, blah blah blah. Yeah, then the rubber monster suits were really fun. I lost track of my other windows here. There we go. Okay, so the dental world is just the dental world is just a waiting room. It's just music. Apparently, we're not allowed to go there. The material world, then. Let's take a look at that. So saith Jesus, Camembert Messiah. When you're 16 years old and you just brought home the most popular student to your school, you want to become best friends so your own popularity will improve. You quietly open the front door, the coast looks clear, but oh no, in from the kitchen steps your mother with the best of intentions. She immediately pipes up with that, what you consider to be the most embarrassing or pet phrases. Welcome to our home, make yourself comfortable and taste my buttocks, grandfather, daddy's lap, acne, blemishes, taste my grandfather. That's weird. Ooh.
The recorded tour.
It's like a... All right, so we get a recorded tour of, It's like a museum.
The last man-eating city tiger of Oslo.
I see. So this is like a museum. This is somebody's personal museum. So that's a preview of the material world, what we'll be seeing next time. Also, let's see what's in the spiritual realm. Goofy voice box. A man searching for enlightenment. Welcome to hell. Which is, like, Las Vegas. Answer or be mocked. Lost little boy, I don't care. I no longer care for these questions. Okay, so this is the sort of thing we can expect. The spiritual realm, which is like Las Vegas, apparently, or at least the hell part. I'm sure there's going to be like heaven and hell, whereas the material world is all about material things, like a museum. A museum's like material things. So that's going to be interesting. So we're going to save it as the afterlife. Or that doesn't quite fit. CD 2. Halfway. We're halfway through the game. We're on CD 2. We made it to CD 2. We're halfway through the game, approximately. So thank you very much for tuning in. I'll see you guys next time I play this, and tomorrow. Tomorrow we're gonna be playing, Don't Starve Together, first up it's Roblox at 7, and then Don't Starve Together at 10. I might be doing something at 4 as well, depending on how I feel, how energetic I feel after tonight, because, I don't know, I got some stuff going on. But I was thinking about playing the game Birthright as my 4 o'clock game, because, well, there's this game called Birthright that I got working recently, and it's an older one that I used to play, and I feel like messing with it. So that might occur if I still feel like messing with that later on. Anyways, I'll see you guys tomorrow. Thanks for watching this. It's been fun and funny. And good night, and I'll see you tomorrow.